calculating RMR to lose weight. If you're interested in long-lasting weight loss, then there are some things you will need to know about your body. One of the most important parts of losing weight is knowing how many daily calories your body burns. Many people spend time counting the calories they take in, but don't bother to figure out how many calories they are burning. This balance between energy taken in and energy burned is the key factor to losing weight and keeping it off. Most people understand the energy in side of the equation, but it's also important to understand the energy out side of the energy balance equation. The first step to losing weight and keeping it off is understanding your RMR. What is RMR? RMR is the amount of calories your body burns each day. Since you will need to burn more calories than you take in to lose weight, it is vital to understand how to calculate this number. First, let's look at the three ways our bodies burn calories, which is known as the Total Daily Energy Expenditure, or TDEE. First is the resting metabolic rate, or RMR. All humans need to burn a certain amount of calories just to stay alive and maintain proper body functions. This number depends largely on the size of the person and how quickly their body's metabolism works. Second, the thermic effect of food, TEF. This is the amount of calories it takes to metabolize food. It usually makes up about 10% of the total caloric burn in a given day. This number doesn't vary. Third, voluntary physical activity level, or PAL. This is the part of caloric burn that you can control. If you're really interested in losing weight and keeping it off, then PAL is the most important and controllable factor. People that do not exercise regularly usually have a PAL that is 55% above their RMR. Getting PAL higher is the best way to lose weight. The RMR equation. The first thing you will need to do to calculate your caloric burn is to estimate your RMR. By knowing your RMR, you can calculate your TDEE, which is a good first thing to losing weight. For example, if we know that RMR is around 1600 calories a day, then we can predict that TDEE will be around 2480 calories per day. First, we need to calculate your RMR. It's important to note that we are making predictions, which should be close, but are not exact. This first calculation will help you build a weight loss program. Men can calculate their RMR with the following equation: 9.99 times their weight in kilograms, plus 6.25 times their height in centimeters, minus 4.92 times their age, plus 5 results in their RMR. For females, you can use the following equation to calculate your RMR: 9.99 times the weight in kilograms, plus 6.25 times the height in centimeters, minus 4.92 times the age, minus 1.61 equals RMR. Be sure to get accurate measurements of both your height and weight. These two pieces of information, along with your sex and age, will determine your RMR. Most people are able to predict their RMR within 5% of the direct measurements done in a laboratory. Once you know RMR, you can figure out how many calories you will need to burn during PAL in order to lose weight. Click the link below to use an online RMR calculator.